Hello, everyone, and welcome. We are live on the red carpet here at Murphy Center at Middle Tennessee State University for the Judds' Love is Alive, the final concert. We are so excited to be here today and cannot wait to bring you a night full of fun and country music. We're going to be your hosts tonight. My name is Sarah Altman.
And my name is Izzy Gutierrez. And we also have Lily on the carpet, who will be joining us in a little bit. Now, we are celebrating the 50-year anniversary of the Murphy Center, but also celebrating, obviously, the Judds coming back. And we want to take a quick look back to their 1991 concert over 31 years ago and see a little bit of footage from then. So let's roll that. Now, this show, I mean, how iconic was it? Over 31 years ago, we got to see the duo in action. This was on their farewell tour, and it was such a great show, completely sold out, completely dominated. It was amazing. And I'm so happy to have them back tonight to have a little, you know, reunion. And obviously, we're going to keep it moving. Now, we are here, and we're so honored to be here because we're going to be honoring and remembering the iconic Naomi Judd tonight, who, you know, we have to talk about. And we are going to move over to Lily, who will be telling us a little bit more.
Hey, I'm here with Rachel Lipsky, who is an MTSU alum. Hi, Rachel. How you doing?
Great. How are you?
I'm doing good. How does it feel to be here, you know, where you graduated and now you're invited here as a special honorary guest to this wonderful concert that's happening tonight?
It's so exciting. I feel like we're a part of history. This will be one for the books for sure. It's such an honor to honor Miss Naomi Judd and then have Wynonna and all of her amazing special guests do the same thing tonight. And just to be a part of it is going to be wonderful.
That's fantastic. So what have you been up to since you've graduated?
I'm about to go on my 7th Armed Forces Entertainment Tour to entertain our troops overseas over Christmas and New Year's. I've released a lot of new music and just keep writing and touring and working.
It's amazing. So I see you're singing the national anthem for one of our football games.
Yes. Next Saturday, November 12th, a salute to the Armed Forces, which will be so much fun.
Well, thank you for chatting with me here, Rachel. What's up with you over there, Sarah?
Hey, Lily. And I was just going to say, just a few minutes ago, we were on the red carpet here. Our other host, Izzy, was talking to our president at Middle Tennessee State University, Dr. McPhee. So here's a clip of what they were talking about.
Hello, everyone. I am here with President McPhee. Now, President McPhee, tell me about how important it is for us to have this amazing event here at the Murphy Center for MTSU.
I think this is really significant. It allows us to really showcase this great university, not only the academic programs and a world-class media and entertainment college, but also the incredible students and the experience our students in that program are getting on a world-class level.
I totally agree with you. Now, tell me, how do you think this university and this event is going to help our university bring more concerts in the future to the Murphy Center?
I think the fact that we have spent a multi-million dollar renovation of the facility, the production of this program will show to other artists that this is first class. And obviously, there isn't a bad seat in the house. It's a very intimate arena, and it will allow the talents to really show their excellence. So we're looking forward to having much more of this kind of high-profile concert at our university.
I totally agree with you. As you mentioned, we just had the new reservation, the new updates on our building, and it's a 50-year anniversary, which is super exciting. And how do you think that this having this event again just helps our students and grow their knowledge of entertainment?
Well, our students are going to be exposed to the best of the best in the business. The opportunity to see live and in person some of the experts in the field, in the music business, the production, the songwriters, the performance. You can't really put a dollar value on that. So it's really a win-win, and we are honored to have the Judd, Wynonna, and all of her A-list guests here showing their talent to this community and to this university.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for this interview, and I can't wait to see the show tonight.
Great.
Thank you.
And HunterGirl has joined us now on the red carpet, and Lily is back with another interview. So, Lily, what's happening there?
All right. Hi, everyone. I'm joined here today with HunterGirl. How are you?
Good. How are you doing?
Good. So how does it feel to be back in Murphy Center just under 4 years after you graduated from this very same place.
Oh my gosh, it's incredible. It's my first time back and just get to see everybody and seeing some of the professors that I went to class with. And it's just been absolutely incredible. I love MTSU and I'm just really proud to be a Blue Raider right now.
I see you've been busy after graduation. You were the runner up on season 20 of American Idol. What have you been doing since then?
So I've been working on new music, been writing a lot of songs. I'm actually on tour right now with Noah Thompson. And then I just had a new single release last week called Hometown Out of Me.
That is awesome. So you work a lot with Freedom Sings USA and yeah. Operation Song. Can you talk a little bit more about your work with them?
Yeah, so basically what I do is I write with veterans about things they've been through whenever they served, and I turn that into a song. And I love getting to do what I do. We're actually having a banquet, I guess, Saturday for our female Trailblazers class for all the female veterans. And probably after this carpet, I'm going to go sign some CDs with Freedom Sings, and we're going to be giving those out on Saturday. So it's going to be awesome.
That is amazing, the work you've been doing after you've graduated from MTSU. You have been busy, busy.
Aw, thank you.
Can you tell me a little bit about how your time at MTSU has helped you shape your career?
You know, being at MTSU completely changed my life. Like, the friends that I made here, the professors, just the music, you know, I learned so much about myself while I was at MTSU, and I think that this college has so much to offer for anybody that wants to be a musician, anybody that wants to be in media, and the connections that I made here, the knowledge that I got here completely transformed my life, and I wouldn't be anything without MTSU for sure.
All right, well, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful night.
So good to meet you.
So good to meet you.
Keel, the Dean of Media and Entertainment at Middle Tennessee State University. How are you feeling? Are you excited?
I'm so excited. You know, this was put together really quickly, but we've still been waiting. It felt like a long time to get it here, and now it's here. And we're so proud to show off our and our students who are doing such great work. And everybody's so impressed, so we're excited.
Yes, I was just about to say, we have so many students and alum working here tonight. What does that say for MTSU and our college, just having that many people representing MTSU working tonight?
You know, we've had alumni involved since the beginning of this, from alumni working at Sandbox, which is the promoter, to alumni working at CMT, to alumni who work in the press now, who were at the press conference. I just saw Cindy Watts come in, our alumni who's working for People Magazine. We have our students involved. So I think it shows that MTSU is the place to go if you want to have success in media and entertainment.
I agree. I mean, I think it's an amazing experience for everyone involved, and we're all super excited, I can say for myself. So what are you most proud about for tonight's event? Would you say that the MTSU involvement there?
Well, I'm proud of several things. First of all, I'm proud of the importance that MTSU plays in the industry. I'm also proud of the role Murphy Center has played in the entertainment industry. You know, this marks the 50th anniversary of Murphy Center, and it was also site of the historic Judds farewell concert in 1991. So it's an important part of country music, and I love especially that this is a concert for women in country music to show their support of Wynonna, because, you know, the Judds built a bridge to country music for several generations of women who were inspired to move here and pursue careers. And, you know, with the death of Naomi, the country music industry is now allowed to return the favor to Wynonna and show her that love and support. So this is a special night. I keep hearing over and over again, full circle moment. Nick Duggar, who was so involved in this production, talked about how he was here in 91. I ran into a reporter who said, I was a senior in 1991 and my boyfriend took photos. I was in the audience here in 1991. I'm proud to say my seats are better tonight, but I did buy them. I did buy them. So many people had a connection to that first show. I was talking to Stacy Cato, who was at CMT now, and he said, I remember that show, watching on TV that show in 1991, going, what is that industry about? And now he's here as an executive at CMT. So, and personally, I'm so excited to show off Murphy Center.
Me too. I think it's a great opportunity, and we're super excited. Well, thank you for talking to us tonight. I hope you have a great time at the concert.
Thank you. We're so excited.
what a great interview. And I'm also here with Andrew Ottman, the vice president of our school. And tell me a little bit about how excited are you to be here tonight?
This is an incredibly exciting evening. I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud of all of our hosts and all the students who are making this entire experience possible in front of the cameras, behind the cameras.
Now, I mean, we have plenty of students working this event. We have behind the stage, we have a choir, we have everyone just continuing to work. Our MTS students are running around this place. How did you put this crew together?
Well, it's a great crew. They put themselves together. Middle Tennessee News, of course, a great partner in what we do on True Blue TV. Obviously, we've got the College of Liberal Arts combined choirs doing a fantastic job. They'll actually be in the performance. The media arts production run by Professor Gordon and the truck. This would be a good time to throw it to the truck if Bob's listening to me.
Great folks there.
And our School of Journalism and Strategic Media, Department of Media Arts and Recording Industry students all coming together for this.
Yeah, can we take a look at the truck? I mean, what a great opportunity to be able to work in the truck. Over the summer, I got to go to Bonnaroo, which was an incredible opportunity. And I mean, it's unbelievable the work they do. It's so exciting to see everything they put into the truck, the equipment, the students, everything is so exciting. So I'm really happy to be here. What artists are you excited to see tonight?
Well, one just went by behind us, Wynonna, of course. I'm very excited to see her. And obviously, there's so many great performers that are going to come together, celebrate the legacy of the Judds, and honor Wynonna and her family.
Yes, and as we mentioned earlier, it's the 50-year anniversary of the Murphy Center, which is such an iconic. Can you tell me a little bit about the renovations and everything going on here?
Well, obviously, 50 years, we've worn this building out to a degree. We had to put some real money into it to make it better. And Dr. McPhee, through his commitment to making sure we've got great facilities, has really done a fantastic job of getting this place concert ready.
And I'd love to take a look at that package really fast a little bit about the renovations that happened here at the Murphy Center.
Murphy Center is just an icon for this area. I mean, it's just been an incredible facility for so many different individuals, both for the university and for the community. I first came to the Murphy Center back in 2001, I believe it was, as the director. One of the challenges that we had at that time, when the sun came into the glass house, it would tend to sort of blind the players that were on the court. And so one of the things that they did was they extended some vinyl plastic between the gaps in the bleachers. That helped keep the glare down on the floor, allowed the players to play and not have to worry about the glare on the in the facility.
SageGlass offers a solution for that. We have almost full glare control and we really provide a comfortable space that is not taxing on the eyes. I am Brooke Graham and I am the SageGlass Customer Success Manager. And the mission of my role is really to just ensure that the customer has an amazing experience with our product.
What makes SageGlass Smart Windows smart is that they tint or clear in an automated mode based on software. We're reading light conditions, sky conditions, the position of the sun, so the glass is responding to all those variables. And then ultimately, people can always override that automated behavior through a mobile app, a touch panel on the wall, or integration with a building management system.
The project started with formulating the team, which is ESA, the parent company, and McInerney Glass. The design portion took a year, and the installation portion took 360 days. It took 16 semis full of glass and over 1,300 pieces, and we have 33,000 square feet of glass in the project. The initial part of the glass came down, and of course we had to go in and prepare for any kind of bad weather in case it happened before the glass was replaced. It took a team of technicians and installers to make sure that the building was always watertight, that it was always functioning. One of our mandates was that Murphy Center was never to go offline. We worked through storms, we worked through games, we worked through graduations, and we just kept plugging along, working our way around the building until the final piece of glass was put in.
When this opportunity came by and SageGlass showed us what this could do, it was a game changer. I mean, it really, really was. We were able to take the blinds down and now we can let the sun and the automation do the work for us, as opposed to having to manually raise and lower the blinds in order to eliminate the glare.
I see universities benefiting from a relationship with SageGlass by overall comfort and wellness. We know that when people are comfortable, they perform at a higher level.
The thing I love most about it is that it is something that I guess everyone driving around the facility has had an opportunity to see the upgrade and to admire it and to appreciate what the Murphy Center is all about and everything that it has meant for the people living in this community and the students and faculty and staff.
It's very sentimental to Murfreesboro city and community. Everybody recognizes this anchor on the corner of MTSU.
I look forward to the Murphy Center being able to do everything that it has done up until this point, hosting athletic events, concerts, speeches, graduations, all of those things for another 50 years. Because I think it's that well built and it is iconic.
Elvis Presley has played here 5 times.
It's incredible. If you walk the concourse of Murphy Center, you'll see a picture of Elvis and talking about his history here in Murphy Center.
That is completely unbelievable. We also have had Billy Joel, Tina Turner, Elton John, Stevie Wonder, Dolly Parton. I mean, such legends have played this arena, and I literally had no idea before I even came here. So I'm so excited to be a student and be working this event. I am so thrilled to be here. And you've actually been running around this place, working, seeing everything together. Have you seen anything a little bit that's been going on tonight?
Well, of course, we've seen a lot going on here. This is really becoming the center of country music for this one moment in time and all of the people that make a difference.
Thank you.
Here.
We're actually going to go over to Sarah, who's with Ashley McBryde. Let's see what's going on over there.
Hi, everybody. I'm here with, Brandi Carlile. Not Ashley McBryde, but Brandi Carlile. We're super excited. How are you feeling tonight being here in Murphy Center with the Judds tonight?
I'm really excited. I'm really honored. It's all very nostalgic for me. I could not be more honored and excited to be here.
So have you been a Judds fan before, and what was it like joining the tour? And I've seen it's a tour full of influential female artists. How does it feel to be a part of such a strong group of women?
Well, girl, first of all, my first, second, and third concert were all the Judds. I saw them for the first time when I was 7, and then 8, and then 9 with my mother. And it was a big part of the building blocks of kind of who our family was and who we became. We all started singing really young, and the Judds sort of showed us that we could do it and that we could find a way to relate to each other and get along even if we didn't always naturally. And, you know, so it's so funny to be here in my 40s now, looking back all those years ago on what that experience was like and how it was such a part of the building blocks of who I am, not just as an artist, but as a mom and a daughter. And it makes me feel like really big things can happen to anyone, because if being allowed to be included in something like this could happen to me, it could happen to you or anybody else.
That's amazing to hear. I mean, because we are a school of many aspiring artists, and I would like to say just the atmosphere. You said you're a mother, you have a daughter.
Two
daughters.
Yes.
And you know, this is a concert about the loss of a mother. What's different about this concert and the feelings, the atmosphere around it because of that loss?
It's really different. I think early on in one of these concerts, you know, Wynonna got up on stage and she said, "We're here to celebrate life after death." And so that's really what it's about. It's about celebrating life after death and knowing that, as Ashley put it one night, you know, we may never be able to get over something like this, but we can always get through it. And one thing that the audience has when they come to a Judds concert right now is they have a purpose. They have a belief that they're there not just to celebrate, you know, the 90s and the amazing Judds music and all the nostalgia that conjures up, but they're there to support a person who has gone through something really difficult. An audience with a purpose is a beautiful thing.
I agree. Well, thank you so much for talking with us. I hope you have a great concert and break a leg tonight.
Thanks for talking with me. You're doing awesome.
Thank you. And now we're going to take a look at Wynonna talking about this concert and what it means to her.
So this is a big, fat, hairy deal for me. And 31 years ago, almost to the day, I did my last concert with my mom. And we are recreating it in November the 3rd, on November the 3rd, at the Murphy Center. We are... When you're hot, you're hot. When you're not, you're not. So we are taking full advantage of the love and support. I will tell you, as an artist, I've never experienced this kind of emotion at a show. there's something going on. Hunter, I text you and show you that every night they're singing so loud that I stand back from the microphone and just weep because there's a revival taking place. And I think it's because of the death of Mom and also the life that I've had for 39 years on the road, and the fans grew up with me, and they're losing their parents and they're bringing their mothers, and it's just a chance for people to express themselves, and boy are they. And it's remarkable what is taking place, and I feel like I'm just the messenger.
Thanks for joining us. I hope you stick around. We're going to go to a quick commercial break and we'll be right back. Thanks.
Welcome, everyone. I am joined here by Little Big Town. Hello.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. So how does it feel to be here playing a role in honoring the Judds' legacy tonight?
Well, we gotta step it up. Because Y brings it, and we've had the pleasure of being on the tour, you know, these past few weeks, and she's just enjoying this, like, love celebration from the fans, and to come back here where they were 31 years ago with the most, like, iconic performance ever, and to come back here to celebrate is just, it's perfect.
It's amazing. So you guys aren't only busy with this night as well, but I hear you guys are going on tour with George Strait and Chris Stapleton in 2023.
It's not bad.
Yeah, I mean, yes. How can we get any better? I mean, it's a dream come true. Both of these tours are.
Well, thank you, thank you. And you just had an album release back in September, Mr. Sun.
We did.
Tell me, how's the success been from that? How does it feel?
It's great. I mean, the fans are really embracing the music, and we've been able to share, you know, some of it on some TV stuff, and we're excited to get back out on tour to share, like, more of the record. But yeah, thank you for asking.
That's amazing. So the one song I've heard is Girl Crush, and can you tell me a little bit of the impact that that's had on not only the country music industry, but the music industry as well?
Well, our friends Lori McKenna, Hillary Lindsay, and Liz Rose wrote that song, and we were lucky enough to hear it first, and they're dear friends of ours, and we write with them a lot, and I think it was the right song at the right time with the right production, with the right artist, and that's like lining up the magical stars, you know, and it came out, and it culturally just had an impact because the song was so interesting and provocative, and it really is a credit to those women as songwriters, and we were lucky that we heard it first.
So you're honoring women tonight, and your song Girl Crush also honors women. Do you have a message to any women in the industry?
Buckle up, have tough skin, work hard, show up. And yeah, I mean, the women right now in this town, we were talking with some friends the other day, I think are writing some of the best music out there, and we need to hear women's voices, and we're not hearing them enough on radio.
The show tonight's a good.
Yeah, testing.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, it works.
Check it out. It works.
Yeah, all right. Well, thank you so much for your time here tonight, and we're going to go to Sarah, who's talking to Ashley McBryde.
Yeah, or Pop.
I'm here with Ashley McBryde here today. How are you feeling? Are you super excited for this concert tonight?
I am. I'm excited, and I'm also a little bit nervous.
I'm here, right there with you. So tell me, performing with someone so influential as Wynonna, what is it like, and how is she maybe an inspiration or a role model for the group of women that are performing with her tonight?
There's two things when you're singing with Y. One, you're having a blast with your friend, and then every once in a while you'll realize that that's Wynonna Judd, and you kind of look at, and sometimes I've forgotten words in the middle of it. I'm like, I can't believe this is happening. And as far as being an inspiration, I've learned some stuff from Y that I tend to be kind of the loudest or most animated person in the room. I'm sure that's a defense mechanism of some kind. But watching her carry herself with such poise and such grace has taught me so much. Like, maybe that means more about being a strong woman than putting everybody on their heels.
And you said there, all of these women performing today and on the tour are these powerful. How is that dynamic with so big personalities, big careers? How was that balance like, you know, with nobody trying to steal each other's spotlight or anything like that?
Yeah, and we're all pretty much really careful to make sure we're not stepping on each other, which is so funny. And I knew that there was a chance when I got into the scene that you wouldn't be welcomed, right? The people would be, that's not how country music is at all. So today at soundcheck and rehearsal, we're having a blast. Me and Brandi and Kelsey and Martina were arm in arm by the end of the show, the song that we were running. So everybody's just been super, it's just real chummy and real bro-y. That bro-y sounds bad. That sounds bad. I don't like that. It's just very, I don't know, there's a lot of inclusiveness and togetherness.
I can really feel the love in the room, especially when I'm here. And, you know, just because it is an honoring concert for Wise Mother. So, yeah, you can really feel the love in that room. And going off on you, you are nominated for 5 Country Music Awards. What is it like receiving those nominations? How did you feel when you got that news?
I was blown away, and I have been every time. And so I wondered for a minute if you ever get used to that. I don't think you do. That's great.
Yeah, I mean, so are you? Is there something you're most excited about going into the award show with part of your work that you're most excited about being nominated for?
It's always the coolest to be nominated in Female Vocalist of the Year. But also, Music Event of the Year, to stand with Carly and accept that would be a really, really nice thing.
My fingers are crossed for you. And just a few more questions about tonight. I always want to know, do you guys have any pre-show rituals going into such a big concert that you maybe do together or separately?
I do, and my band and I do before our shows. So since I've been without my band, I've started doing miniature versions of those rituals with my glam team. So wardrobe and glam, we stand side stage and do all of the high fives and all of the key words, which rock bottom has been a magical word on this tour. So we try to make sure we hit all of those things before we go to the stage.
Rock bottom, what's the meaning behind that?
It's a song, and it's one of my favorites. And it was one night Wynonna surprised me and said, you're going to sing it. And it's not one of the ones I was planning on doing. So I was like, ah. And so then I just had to step it up and do it. So it's been an inside joke ever since.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much for spending the time to talk with us tonight. I hope you have a great concert and break a leg tonight.
No one has more fun than me. I won't have it.
I agree. I believe it. Have a great rest of your night. Nice to meet you too. All righty. Well, we're going to take another look at Wynonna and more things that she has to say about tonight.
Yes.
Aaron Kintrell with News Channel 5 out of Nashville.
Hi.
What's it like partnering with one of the biggest universities, MTSU? They're going to be hosting this.
They love me. They love me so much. It's their anniversary, too. So you're taking two anniversaries and putting them together. It's like the greatest prom ever. 50-something years for them? 50 years for them. So it's 50 for them, 31 for me. And we were a big deal back then, and we did it at MTSU, and that was our final concert. They really love the fact that I'm coming back there because of that, and I think it will give them an opportunity to get some attention, which, whatever it takes, right? So we're going to have a big party, and that's what life is about, having celebrations.
And a big party is really what's going to happen tonight. We are so excited for real for her to be back at Murphy Center. And now here's a little package about HunterGirl, one of the artists we had on the red carpet a little bit earlier.
So we're here on behalf of the 120,000 plus alumni
and the 25,000 friends and fans at MTSU to let you know how proud we are of you. So I'm going to ask Professor Blackman to present to you a plaque proclaiming you an honorary professor of Middle Tennessee State University.
I'm a professor.
Wow.
Yes. So I'm here with Jackie Jones. She is an alumni of MTSU. How excited are you to be back here tonight?
It is awesome to be able to be at a show at MTSU and be a part of something back at my alma mater.
So you went to school for something, mass communications was that. So what is it like seeing kind of your college live and in person right now doing all this hard work?
I am really impressed. We never did a live red carpet when I was in school, so I'm pretty impressed with you guys. This is pretty awesome and grown quite a bit.
Thank you. Well, we're gonna say goodbye to News Channel 5 audience. Stick around though, we have more of the show later tonight. We're gonna go to a break. Stick around. Everyone, and welcome back. If you're just now joining us, we are your hosts today. My name is Sarah Ottman.
And my name is Izzy, and I am so excited to be here on the red carpet. As we mentioned earlier, this is literally one of the coolest experiences as an MTSU student I've probably ever had. And I just want to take a quick look to the Charles Daniels package and just see a little bit of video. So let's clip to that.
And we've already announced that our facility, which now will be known as the Charlie and Hazel Daniels Veterans and Military Family Center, will be a significant addition to our university. Charlie and Hazel, through the Journey Home Project, have given substantially, ladies and gentlemen, to our center, not once, but twice. And they expected nothing in return. General Huber helped us here make our gratitude more tangible by advocating for this center and the good it can accomplish. Charlie and Hazel took a step further in investing in this center that will make it stronger, more visible, and more vital.
Good morning. I don't know what to say. I'm just honored that you've done this for us, and we appreciate it. Thank you so much. And what Charlie always says, ain't it great to be alive and be in Tennessee?
Is that pathway, that journey that will bring us back home to the communities and the businesses that we have spent our adult life protecting, to provide us that sense of home where we have sacrificed with our family members, where we have protected the families of the world, often at the expense of our own. That concept of home is so profound, and the Journey Home Project has accomplished that. I would like to present to you the 2016 Country Music Hall of Fame inductee, Charlie Daniels.
Brothers and sister rednecks, current and former members of the armed forces, Hazel and myself are honored beyond the ability to articulate the way we feel today. Dr. McPhee and your staff, I want to acknowledge your efforts in procuring space on one of our state's busiest and most populated colleges. Share this honor with my fellow board members of the Journey Home Foundation, and every donor, large and small, who helped our foundation make a contribution to help bring this to fruition. Approaching my 80th birthday, I can't remember a time in my life when I didn't have the greatest respect, admiration, and gratitude for the United States military. I mean this from my heart of hearts, no matter if you find them in a base in this country or some hellhole over in Afghanistan or Iraq, they're the best we've got. There are no finer Americans. I want to thank you, Gold Star parents, for raising patriots. I thank you for your sacrifice. I want to thank you folks here who served today for your service. Greater love have no man than he laid down his life for his friends.
Middle Tennessee State University helped honor Daniels at that event. He was, of course, an honorary Brigadier General in the Tennessee State Guard. So Army Lieutenant General Keith Huber from MTSU attended the event to render military honors to the country music icon. Huber says that he had worked with Daniels for years. The general presented the American flag on his coffin to his wife Hazel at the conclusion of the ceremony.
Thank you, guys. I do want to take a quick second and say that my alma mater, Middle Tennessee State University, helped the Opry present tonight's fantastic Salute to Troops show. MTSU is home to the Charlie and Hazel Daniels Veterans and Military Family Center, the largest veteran support center on any university campus. General Keith Huber, who worked with Charlie to open the Daniels Center, is here tonight, along with our beloved Hazel Daniels and Charlie Daniels Jr. General, just want to say thank you for helping further Charlie's legacy of supporting our troops. And to Hazel and Charlie Jr. specifically, I love you, we love you, and we miss Charlie very, very much.
All right, and we're back here on the red carpet with Nancy DeGennaro and Andrew Ottman. How are you feeling tonight, Andrew? How's it going?
I feel good because I am basically...
It is live, but we're not...
I asked Nancy to join us.
But I really appreciate you doing this.
Oh, yeah, no problem.
Important so I'll just be journalists that we've had in covering Murfreesboro, Nashville, and Middle Tennessee for so many years. She's just announced her early retirement from USA Today Network and the Tennessean and the Daily News Journal. I had the honor of working with her at the Daily News Journal before I joined MTSU, and we kind of wanted to surprise her and get her on the red carpet because she's usually the person being interviewed, not the other way around. So I want, on behalf of Middle Tennessee State University, your alma mater, I want to congratulate you for everything you've done to make our community better. And we're going to put a microphone in your mouth now, and we're going to let you say a few things about your career. Talk about your most important, and when you're looking back on your career as a journalist, what's mattered the most to you?
I think people have mattered the most, and making connections with people. They make my job easier. You know, and if I don't know somebody, I know somebody who will know somebody. So if you're just starting out in the business and mass communication, you just need to make connections. You know, it's been great, and it's come full circle, you know, graduating in 1995, a 27-year career. I started at the Daily News Journal right out of school, and you know, one of my teachers worked at the Daily News Journal, and they said, you need to hire her, and they did, and it's been a long run. It's been wonderful, so.
So I've got a couple more. And poor Lily, she's doing such a great job. We've got one microphone, we're improvising here, but Nan, you've started something really that it's going to be a hard act to follow. You've developed this niche in our market about restaurant writing, Good Eats. Talk a little bit about your passion about that, because it's really made a difference for a lot of newcomers and a lot of old-timers like me in the Murfreesboro market.
Sure. I run Good Eats in the Borough and beyond. You're on that page?
I'm on that page.
That's awesome. Yeah, it's got 17,000 members and growing. And it's just featuring, I really focus on local restaurants, locally owned restaurants. And it's just, you know, we talk about food, we talk about, you know, what's good, what's not. But I focus, what I think people enjoy the most is that I focus on good. There's plenty of bad reviews out there, but I want to know the good of our community. I want to know those stories behind, not just the food, what it tastes like, but you know, how did the chef come up with that dish? How did, you know, they get in the business to begin with? So, yeah, come join Good Eats in the borough and beyond.
Well, thank you so much, Nancy. I'm going to hit it to Izzy, who has a special MTSU alumni guest.
Hello, everyone. We are here with Laura Douglas. Tell me a little. Okay, first of all, you're an MTSU alumni. Welcome back. How does it feel to be back?
I am. You know, it feels very full circle for me to be back here at MTSU. I graduated. We won't say the graduating year, but I did journalism just like all of you. I worked at Channel 10 News, so it's a special night for me to be here.
Now, tell me a little bit about your role tonight and what you're doing tonight for the show.
Yes, so I'm a field producer, and so I interview artists on the red carpet. I'm not always on camera, but I'm behind the camera and asking questions, and I have loved it. I actually did my internship through MTSU to work at CMT, and that internship turned into a job. And I was there for almost 10 years, and I still do a lot with CMT, as you can tell.
First of all, I mean, if you're looking for some interns, wow, that's crazy, I'm sparkling. Anyway, but what advice do you have for students tonight that are watching the show and want to continue working in the music industry?
I would say that Nashville, if you're staying here, is the biggest small town ever. Stay humble, kind. It's a stressful industry, but it's really, really fun. As far as entertainment news goes, every week, I'm freelance now, every week it's something different, and that's what I love the most.
Thank you so much for talking to me tonight. I'm so excited to see the show, and let's kick it over to Lily, who also has another interview for us.
Hi, I'm joined here with another MTSU alum. We have Yasmin Muhammad. How you feeling being here tonight?
Just really stressed out in a good way. I'm just working a lot of different crews right now, but it feels weird to be back at MTSU, I'm not going to lie. Probably because the time that I was here, I don't think I ever came to the Murphy Center. Like even my graduation, I think I had them mail me my diploma. So
that's awesome. So you're a writer and producer for CMT. Can you tell me a little bit more about that?
So I currently am a director of production for music and live events. I was a former writer producer for CMT. So basically I traffic a show from development to delivery that when it goes on air. Can I start over on that? Sorry.
We are live.
Okay, gotcha. There you go. That's basically what I do. So I touch every show that comes in and then airs out of New York in our NOC. So I manage all the crews, post, the doc crews, just making sure everything moves smoothly and everything gets to air. So.
Well, that's amazing, and you must have had so much skill to be able to do that, and thank you for that. So tell me about your passion for storytelling.
I think everybody has, at some point in their life, some sort of passion for storytelling on anything that they're interested in. I grew up with a father who was from an island, and my mother was from an island, and I kind of call it the village stories. They used to just tell stories about things that would happen in the village, and I think I just always grew up listening to stories, and a lot of cultural things get transferred down through stories, so I think I just was always into storytelling, and I didn't realize it. I remember when I was at MTSU, I was working at Home Depot, actually, and Home Depot is really interesting when you're an employee because you have a customer that walks up to you, they give you a problem, and you have a minute and a half to tell them what to do and how to do it. So I think I was always storytelling on some level. And so I just think it just kind of naturally came to me. And I didn't even know it was happening to me until I actually started producing shows.
Well, that's amazing. Yasmin, I want to thank you so much for your time. And we're going to cut to a package on MTSU at the Grammys.
I'm so sorry.
Now look who is back at the Grammys. Those are students from Middle Tennessee State University. They are in Las Vegas ahead of the award show tomorrow night. Media and arts students are cheering on 9 nominees who are MTSU alumni. In the last 2 decades, alumni, faculty, or students have racked up 125 Grammy nominations. You can watch the Grammys tomorrow night right here on News Channel 5. The show starts at 7.
Well, I'm back here on the red carpet again with Andrew Ottman, the vice president of MTSU. Hi, Andrew.
Hi, Sarah.
And we're also here with Cindy Watts, who is also an MTSU alumni. Hi, Cindy.
Hi. Hello.
So I'm really honored to bring Cindy to the show, the program, because I'm very proud of Cindy. One of our Prague graduates, as Sarah mentioned, she's a writer now for People Magazine. She covered the music industry for the Tennessean and USA Today for years, a CMT media writer of the millennium or something like that.
Oh, no, CMA. I have a trophy that says CMA on it that I got for doing a job well in 2015, but I don't remember exactly what the award was called. It's not in my brain.
What you've done is covered amazing stories in the music industry. Talk about your favorite moments covering music. I mean, I know you've got a lot to choose from, and I'm putting you on the spot, but I know you were there with the opening for the Chris Young Cafe. I know you've been to the Grammys. I know you've been to all of the significant events. Just pick one and talk about something that means to you.
Oh, just pick one. Well, so it was called the Media Achievement Award. Winning that award was really special because that award is given to you by it's the people that you work with every day, by publicists in town, and they kind of vote on it, and it's like them saying, we trust you, you're doing a great job. So that was lovely. Other things that have meant a lot. So I grew up loving Alabama, the country band Alabama, and it was really special to me when Jeff Cook, who plays guitar, came to me to tell the world that he had Parkinson's disease and was having to leave the band. So I was really honored to be trusted with that story. I found out about a publicist in town who was assaulting his employees and had for years and years, and I wrote a story about it, and that business closed. And I had 32 sources, like 32 people who came forward, and then I was able to write that story, and that business shut down. So that made me feel good. I've got to do cool things. I almost threw up on Garth Brooks' jet.
Well, we thank you so much for joining us today, and it's a great inspiration for current students for you to be here. And now we're going to take a look at President McPhee, and he has a couple of words to say for us today.
Hello, this is Dr. Sidney A. McPhee, president of Middle Tennessee State University. A few days ago, we held a very special event to announce a year-long celebration of Murphy Center's 50th anniversary. We recall its rich history, and in doing so, I told the audience that the future and potential of the Glass House remains bright. And part of that rich history was forged in 1991, when Murphy Center was the site of the national telecast of the Judds Farewell Concert. This emotional and powerful performance is legendary, not only on our campus, but the entire country music world. Wynonna, with your announcement today and the national telecast that will come from your concert, you are launching our second half century with style and significance. This concert will join the rich history of Murphy Center, an appropriate bookend to the memorable 1991 concert. I also would be remiss not to thank Wynonna for allowing so many of our students from our world-class media and entertainment college to join her production team for this event. This is another example of the way Middle Tennessee State University provides strong worldwide experiences. I look forward to seeing all of you in Murphy Center, Murfreesboro, Tennessee, to enjoy this wonderful reunion.
Thank you so much, President McPhee, for those kind words. Now we have alumni Craig Morgan. He's such an amazing country music star, and we just want to take a quick look of him talking at the Daniel Center. Let's look at it.
Put your hands together, Craig Morgan.
Thank you very much. Middle Tennessee State University is the home of the Charlie and Hazel Daniels Veteran Military Family Center. Hazel Daniels and her son, Charlie, are here tonight. We miss him. With them is General Huber from MTSU and the Army Reserve Command Sergeant Major Andrew Lombardo. Hazel and Charlie Jr., we love you. we all miss him something terrible. Thank you all for helping further Charlie's legacy, for supporting our troops. God bless you.
And we really do love the Charlie Daniel Center. It does such amazing things for our community. And now for a segment from Out of the Blue, which is one of MTSU's newscasts about Murphy Center and MTSU. Take a look.
Welcome back to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Ottman. The latest edition of MTSU Magazine has just been released, and our cover story highlights the 50th anniversary of the opening of Murphy Center, the iconic multi-purpose facility that is the centerpiece for so many memories from high school and college basketball games and commencements, community events, and classic concerts. University archivist Donna Baker joins us to talk about the legacy and future of this important building. Donna, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Your first time on Out of the Blue.
I know, there's first for everything.
And we're making history by that, right? Okay.
All right.
Too easy. You are the university archivist. Describe that job and what do you do?
There are many sorts of archivists in the world. They maybe do music, like we do here at the Center for Popular Music. Or there might be political, like my colleague at the Gore Center, who takes care of Albert Gore Sr.'s papers, Bart Gordon's, Jim Freeze, or collections that are governmental, like we see at Rutherford County Archives. A university archivist is specifically tasked with taking care of the institutional memory of whatever university they're working at. Mm-hmm. I am the first person to do that at MTSU. Now, that doesn't mean necessarily nobody else was collecting those materials, but in 2011, during our centennial, the president, Sidney McPhee, decided that he needed a university archivist. And I landed at the Gore Center on Halloween of that year.
And here you are.
Here I am.
Well, it's very important. You mentioned the centennial, so many events in the university and documenting that history so vital to the public service we put forth, make sure that folks understand what we do. And one of the things that we're celebrating, we talked about this in the intro, was this is the 50th anniversary of Murphy Center. So you're playing a huge role in that. Talk a little bit about how you're guiding that commemoration.
Sure. Because I have the records, in about 2012, student programming transferred all of their paper records to me, as is appropriate and as part of my job. Mm-hmm. They digitized them, but then they gave me the original pieces. And what came with that was six beautiful boxes of contracts for all the acts who have played at Murphy Center. So I have a wonderful archive full of that material that I can go back and say, oh, this happened, and this is what they asked for, and this is what the ticket might have looked like, or the backstage passes. It's mostly legalese, but it's a lot of good information.
Well, let's take a step back for a second. In 1972, when Murphy Center opened, we were the biggest indoor arena, really, in the greater Nashville area. So what did that mean in terms of the type of acts that we would receive?
First, you know, acts didn't know that we were here. Murphy Center kind of had a little bit of a slow start, but once Harold Smith, who was the program director at the time, kind of figured out how to do it, he knew he had to get big acts. And once he did it, everybody would want to come to Murphy Center, and they did. Elvis was the point. He was the linchpin for everything that we were trying to do. Mm-hmm. And Elvis has played at Murphy Center five times. He had like four in a row, sellout, that stood as a record until Garth Brooks broke it during his amazing run at Murphy Center. When Harold Smith got Elvis, that was it. Mm-hmm. We could ask for any artist and almost get them instantaneously.
Because there really wasn't anything like that in Nashville. That arena was just remarkable for the area. So talk about really briefly some of the acts that we saw.
We've had, of course, Elvis, Garth Brooks. Alabama played here a lot. You could see kind of that country music 80s trend at Murphy Center because Alabama and the Oak Ridge Boys. Elton John has been here several times. Mm-hmm. Tina Turner as well. Billy Joel has been here, yes.
And of course, Charlie Daniels.
Charlie Daniels has had a long history with this university, and not just with the Daniels Center. The second volunteer jam was shot here. It was referred to as the first Southern rock concert ever on film. And of course, that was a big success, and it's one of his lasting legacies. More modern acts, Ludacris has been here. Mm-hmm. Kanye, the aforementioned Kanye, has been here. It's not just that heyday of the 80s, mm-hmm. before the outdoor arenas were built, and they kind of stole our thunder a little bit. Mm-hmm. We had those wonderful big acts, stadium rockers, that went on to be known forever as stadium rockers. They were all coming to Murphy Center.
Yeah, it's really incredible when you see that roster of acts. Elvis recorded one of his live albums here. I think the Judds farewell concert was at Murphy Center, nationally televised on NBC. I mean, so many pivotal moments. And I read this in the Tennessean, that one of those concerts that attracted so many people also attracted Phil Bredesen, who at that time was the mayor of Nashville, sitting in our audience at Murphy Center, and he goes, why doesn't Nashville have a Murphy Center? And that really kind of, he then came back to Nashville and said, I'm going to build an arena in downtown Nashville. And that sort of began the Nashville run of those concerts. But for that time, we were golden, right?
Absolutely.
The building was, of course, more than just entertainment. It is a multi-purpose center. Talk about some of the other uses of Murphy Center.
When this began, the idea of Murphy Center as we know it began when Quill Cope was our president. This idea of, we need a place to have commencement, we need a place to do more community, we definitely need more for our physical education and our athletics to kind of be a home mm-hmm. base for that. It was to be student first, mm-hmm. as always at MTSU. So again, those classrooms and places to do physical education as well as our athletics. Community banquets. We had a banquet here at Murphy Center for Robert Scales, known in the community as T90 Scales. So a African-American activist and community member. There was a banquet for him on the floor of Murphy Center. Wow. And I'm like, what? So all of these wonderful community uses. We now, of course, have the high school basketball tournament here.
Yes, statewide. The high school statewide championship.
Statewide. We have commencements.
Yes.
Exercises from all the high schools. So that's a wonderful opportunity for recruitment. Mm-hmm. Not that the concerts weren't, because, again, if you were a kid and you were coming to a show, again, our students got first dibs, but then the community was welcome to come. And if that was your first experience with MTSU, wouldn't that be a good impetus to come back and actually attend?
Our alums talk about it all the time. And of course, it is the home of the Blue Raider basketball teams, men and women. And so many great memories. We had undefeated regular home seasons just this last year at Murphy Center. And it was really the power of that arena that captivated that. Big investments in this 50th year of the building. A company called SageGlass is putting in new glass in the glass house. What is that going to do to the place?
It is going to completely change the look of Murphy Center. It's still going to be the glass house, but the ability to have a more efficient Murphy Center, mm-hmm. to have a more friendly lighting for our patrons who come to Murphy Center for whatever event. Mm-hmm. All of those things are part of this package for the new glass that's going in.
It is not just ordinary glass. I mean, so much technology going this can manage the temperature, as you said, the density of how much light comes in, so we'll be able to finally control some of those hot spots. There's so much we could talk about this building, but the actual anniversary, of course, December 11th, of this year, we played Vanderbilt, the men's team did, and I know we're looking for a commemorative game for that as well. You're doing something special in the track area around that will debut this basketball season. Talk about that.
What we're trying to create is a little bit of what would be a museum of Murphy Center. So starting with the very beginning, groundbreaking of the building, kind of the early conceptual ideas of the building, to present the games, the meets, the concerts, the highlights of the building, both as a functional building and as what it has symbolically been for so many of our students. That's what we're going to try to put into a timeline that goes all the way around.
It'll be a walking tour.
It's going to be a walking tour of the building.
And of course, we just recently had the Jack Harlow concert, a very popular rising rapper who really captivated and packed the house again. And it was another reminder that the Murphy Center still's got it, right?
Absolutely. We'd love to see more. It's everything in time.
Donna Baker, the university archivist, and now making sure we remember the history of Murphy Center. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
And what a great story that is. You know, we love Murphy Center as students here today. It is great to see this place turn 50 years old, and just seeing over the years how influential this building really has, it's so exciting to see it come back to life tonight for this Judds concert.
Most definitely. I mean, I've had an amazing time here on the red carpet. I got to talk to some amazing alumni, amazing guests. I feel so educated, and I feel so excited for the concert tonight. What was your favorite part tonight?
My favorite moment would have to have been when I was literally sandwiched in between Little Big Town.
One of the best moments
of my life, hands down.
Yeah. Literally unreal. I got to talk to so many amazing people, amazing artists, Brandi, Carlile, I mean, Ashley, McBryde. It was a great experience for us, especially as students wanting to get into this field.
Now definitely make sure to tune in to the real show broadcast in March. I can't wait to watch
the final concert.
Real, the final concert. I mean, obviously I'm excited to watch now, but I can't wait to see the preview then. Well, my name is Isabella Gutierrez.
I'm Sarah Ottman.
I'm Lily Mignara.
And goodbye.
Bye.
Have a great night.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.